Good evening, everyone. I was supposed to do this video sooner, but I'm barely doing it now. This is a tribute to David Roback. He was an American guitarist. Apparently, he sang also, but he was mostly known for being one of the founding members of the band Mazzy Star, along with Hope Sandoval, she being the singer and he the guitarist. Mazzy Star is a band from the 90s. They're one of the bands that basically defined the 90s with one of their songs. When people think 90s, a lot of people think this song, which I will talk about. Their music can be described as dark, haunting, slow, and melancholy. As you know, I enjoy anything dark and inclined, especially when it comes to music and film and art and just basically anything. And I love depressing stuff too. So this is their first album that I got myself into, and the way I found out about them was their second album, and it's called Among My Swan. I got this on eBay, and at the end of this video I'm going to be playing Look On Down from the Bridge. It'll be a song, a tribute song that I will dedicate to David Roback, and I put a little montage together at the end of this video. I hope you'll stick around to listen to that. And in the background, you're listening to one of their songs from their first album. And so this is the first album that I ever got of Mazzy Star. And then I went back to getting this one also on eBay. And it's called So Tonight That I Might See. And when I was talking about that one song, that kind of one of the songs that define the 90s, is the first one that you see. It's called Fade Into You. You must listen to this song if you're into that kind of music. Their music is really something that calms me down. It takes me into a calm embrace of the night. It's just music to be listened to in the dark, having some wine. It can be sexy music too. I can definitely see that if you're into that kind of stuff. And their artwork and their CDs really reflects in their music. It's very just simple, plain, and mysterious. Not to say that the music is plain, but I meant in the sense that it's just obscure and, you know, dark and mysterious. And their music can be described, or their music has various ranges. One song can sound cacophonous to, like, you know, with, it can be very cacophonous, discordant, with many guitars and loud sounds. And they could have a song that's just basically Hope singing and David playing with his guitar and anything else in between. So now I'm going to show you the next CD that I got. And then this one was their third album that I bought. They came out with this album in 1990. I got this one at Amoeba Music, and again with the mysterious artwork. Let me show you the inside really quick here. This came out in 1990, right at the beginning of the 90s. And again, that's really cool right there. And I'm glad I have all their CDs. I like looking at the artwork and stuff. So this is basically, as you could say, my least favorite CD, even though I like all their music. And that's not to say that I don't like this album, but if I had to choose, which one would I say the least favorite? I'm not going to go into details why, but I still like it though. One of the CDs that I really like listening to. And then in 2013, they came out with their final album. It came out in 2013. I got this one on Amazon. And I guess they have something with cats. I never really figured that out. And the inside looks like this. Again, very plain and haunting almost and mysterious. That's David there, and that's Hope Sandoval. And in the background, you could listen to Cry Cry, which comes from my album that I fell in love with them initially. And then let me show you this one, and then the final, I guess, CD of them that I got, which is a single from Fade Into You. I got this one, believe it or not, at Out of a Closet. It's one of those thrift stores. I was just rummaging through their stuff, and I found this gem. It's a single of Fade Into You, and it has two unheard songs that they never put on any of their albums, and really cool. I'm glad I found this gem. It's in really good condition. And that's my Mazzy Star collection that I have, that I ever, you know, bought from them. And I do believe that while David was still alive, they may have recorded some music, so who knows? Maybe we'll be blessed with an album that I hope we'll decide to release one day. And we'll see. I just wanted to talk about this great American guitarist that went away. He passed away based on what I read. I think he had an advanced stage of cancer. Very unfortunate. He will be missed, but his music will always be playing in my home. This is basically my go-to band music many times when I just want to reflect on something or just want to enjoy a quiet night. I could just put on their music over and over and over and over again and play it over and over. It's a kind of music that I just never get bored of. One of my favorite bands of all time. And the only unfortunate thing is, and I will always regret this, I never got to see them live. They came here to LA, I think maybe 3 years ago, or even just 2 years ago. Or was it even last year even? I was so pissed off that I didn't go. I was just, now it'll never happen anymore. I'll never get to see them live. But again, their music will always be in my heart, in my home, and may you rest in peace, David Roback. The music industry will always miss you. Even though you were this mysterious man that never gave much interviews, you never really gave much of your personal life to us, but it was about your music. I will always be grateful to you for that. And Mazzy Star community and the Mazzy Star family, and to Hope Sandoval, my condolences to you guys. And we've lost a great one, but I hope Hope keeps moving on with music. And I know it must be hard on her, and may he rest in peace.